Mood stabilizers are one group of medications that are used to control mood swings in the people. Generally, changes in the mood can be observed in few of the disorders like bipolar disorder, where the mood of the people swings between mania and depression in a cyclic manner. These mood swings can also be observed in schizoaffective disorder, where psychotic symptoms are associated with depressive symptoms. So today in this video, let us discuss the different types of mood stabilizers and how they are given and what are the important side effects. Lithium is one of the important medication that is used as mood stabilizer. However, other medications like anticonvulsants and antipsychotics can also be used to control mood swings in the people. Mania is one of the condition of hyper-excitability, where the people are highly excited. The mood of the people are not stable and they're having exciting ideas and they move from one idea to another very quickly. People are more irritable with racing thoughts and even they are not able to sleep well. All these symptoms are collectively called mania. People may have another condition, depression. Depression is quite opposite to manic phase and the people may have low mood, less energy, feeling tired, hopeless, with negative thoughts. They may have feeling of guilty, worthless, and less interested in many things. They can also have difficulty concentrating and either sleeping too much or not able to sleep. They may also have disturbance in their appetite, leading to either weight gain or weight loss. Hypomania is another condition just like mania, but it is having the milder symptoms. So in the bipolar disorder, the mood of the people may swing from mania to depression or depression to mania. Now, mood stabilizers can be used to control the mood swings in such people. And few of the mood stabilizers can mainly affect manic phase, whereas few other medications can mainly affect depressive phase. So the first one is the lithium. Lithium is used to control the manic phase in the bipolar disorder. And this drug is particularly used for long-term treatment. Lithium can reduce the mood swings in the people by suppressing the manic phase. This medication is available as a tablet as well as liquid. In the form of tablet, it is given as a lithium carbonate, whereas in the form of liquid, it is given as lithium citrate. Lithium is the first choice of medication for the long-term treatment of mania in bipolar disorder. Lithium just acts like sodium, but it replaces the sodium in many of the cells, where it can reduce the excitation. Even the exact mechanism is unknown. Lithium can interfere with signaling pathways like phosphatidyl inositol system. It can also modify the excitation of neurons by replacing the sodium. In this way, lithium can reduce the neuronal activity, thereby it can reduce the excitation. Therefore, it can be used to control the manic phase in the people with bipolar disorder. However, this lithium should be carefully given because it can produce a number of side effects. Few are mild, but few can produce significant effects on the body. One of the important side effects of lithium is the increase in the thirst. Lithium can increase the diuresis, resulting in the loss of more amount of water from the body. This results in the increase in the thirst. Lithium can also produce stomach pain, and the people may have nausea and weakness. Since it is a mineral compound, it can produce a metallic taste in your mouth. And it can also increase the weight gain in the people. Lithium also interacts with many of the other medications like diuretics, cardiac glycosides like digoxin. Therefore, this drug should be carefully combined with other medications. Long-term treatment with lithium can affect the kidneys and it requires few of the regular blood tests to monitor kidney function. Second category of drugs are the anticonvulsants. Anticonvulsants can also reduce the neuronal activity and they can reduce the excitation of the neurons. Apart from their use in treatment of epilepsy, few of the antiepileptics, particularly the new generation antiepileptics, can be used to control manic phase in the bipolar disorder. Anticonvulsants like Valproate, divalproex, topiramate, lamotrigine, and carbamazepine can be used as mood stabilizers. Valproate is particularly used to control the manic phase in the bipolar disorder. It is available as tablets as well as capsules. This medication acts by multiple mechanisms. It can block the voltage-gated sodium channels. Even it can increase the GABA activity and reducing the glutamate action. By all of these mechanisms, valproate can reduce the excitation of neurons. Thereby, it can control hyper-excitability in the people. However, this valproate can produce serious side effects. Particularly, it can produce abdominal discomfort. In order to minimize this effect, it can be given as a divalproex, which is a mixture of valproic acid and sodium valproate in 1:1 ratio. This combination may have less gastric side effects compared with valproate. Other side effects of valproate mainly include dizziness, hair loss, and loss of memory. It can also produce ototoxicity that may result in loss of hearing. Valproate can be used as an alternative for lithium in the long-term treatment of mania in bipolar disorder. Another anticonvulsant is the lamotrigine. Interestingly, lamotrigine is used to control the depressive phase in the bipolar disorder. Just like valproate, lamotrigine acts by multiple mechanisms and it reduces the excitation of the neurons. This drug can produce few of the side effects like drowsiness, dizziness, joint pains, and dry mouth. Another drug is the carbamazepine and its related drug oxcarbazepine. These two drugs can also be used to control the mood swings in bipolar disorder. However, carbamazepine can produce agranulocytosis. Next category of drugs are the antipsychotics. Antipsychotics can stabilize the mood, particularly in the people who are having the mood swings associated with psychotic symptoms. People with psychotic symptoms can hear strange voices, and in few people, these symptoms may be associated with mood swings. In such people, antipsychotics can be used to control the mood swings both in the bipolar disorder as well as schizoaffective disorder. Drugs like olanzapine, risperidone, haloperidol, and quetiapine are particularly used to control mood swings in the people. These antipsychotics again show multiple mechanisms. They can block dopamine receptors as well as they can also block serotonin receptors. And many of these antipsychotics can increase the weight gain as well as they can produce dizziness and drowsiness in the people. Antidepressants. Few of the antidepressants like fluoxetine, citalopram, escitalopram, paroxetine, and sertraline can also be used to control the mood swings in the people. However, many of these antidepressants can reduce the depressive phase and they can stimulate acute manic phase. Therefore, these antidepressants are not used alone and they may be combined with other mood stabilizers or antipsychotic medications. For example, the antidepressant fluoxetine can be combined with olanzapine, which is an antipsychotic. So that's all about the different types of mood stabilizers used in bipolar disorder as well as schizoaffective disorder. Lithium is the first line drug in the treatment of mood swings. However, few of the anticonvulsants like valproate, divalproex, lamotrigine are used as an alternatives for lithium. So that's for today. I hope this video is useful to you. Thanks for watching this video.